celebrating his birth tonight.
Your son is 17.
17.
What's here?
Hello.
Hello. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. My Bonnie lies over the sea. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Last night as I lay on my pillow.
Don't get dirty, Ed.
Last night as I laid on my bed, I stuck my feet out of the window. Next morning, the neighbors were dead.
Hey, Jay and Ed.
Consecutively.
Through college, through coaching Little League.
Rehearsing the night of the show. And the people who come back year after year after year after year.
Last night was our first rehearsal.
I know.
Really?
We always just to see the show.
Yeah, like the numbers.
Jesus,
we actually became friends. I think Yanman became friends with the audience over the years.
There's a dog. Yeah.
Do you guys rehearse yet?
Last night, I'll talk to you.
Why do you say that you never know what's going to happen?
Well, because sometimes things happen at a spur of the moment. You just see something that would be funny. This is an audience participation show. Are you going to see the show tonight?
Yeah.
Well, you'll see what we mean. We drag the people into the audience.
My name is Jay Deckel, my partner is Ed Handy, and we are here tonight to, this one talks to, with my foot. We're here to harass the audience before the show starts. This is called the annual portion.
Oh, hold on, ladies and gentlemen, just a minute, please. Former Mayor Mena would rather stand in the back of the auditorium and talk.
Hi, Bill. Who are you?
You want to sit down, Mr. Mena?
No.
No? Then you want to leave?
No.
You know?
He wants to sing a song.
Did you pay to get in?
No.
You know, when you were mayor, you were important. All right, now when you stare at me, it makes no difference.
I'm a has-been now.
You're a has-been. Bill has-been.
You ready? Yeah. What are we going to sing first, Dan?
We're going to sing a song that Jay and I wrote called I've Been Working on the Railroad.
I've Been Working on the Railroad.
How many have ever heard that?
Raise your hand.
You ever hear that, man? Never heard of that?
Okay.
You ever hear that? Put your hands up if you ever heard of I've Been Working on the Railroad.
I know where you're sitting.
All right, put your hands down if you've never heard of Jay. We're going to have trouble. Ma'am, you haven't done...
I don't think the person you stole from is looking for it either.
You got the table back.
That's nice looking at you. You get a Marshalls?
No.
No? You're a conductor?
Nothing.
You do nothing on the railroad? Oh, you like the post office?
Yeah.
No, that's not... I'm not... Okay, don't cancel my mail. No, you work on the railroad, do you really? What do you do there? You're an electrician? They have electricity on railroad trains? They do? Oh, I work for electricity on the railroad.
This is a public service announcement. If you can squish in so that other people can have seats, we'll run out of seats pretty quick.
Yeah, we've always sold the place three times. Oh, good. Sir, why are you left? You know her?
No.
You don't know her? Did you know her when you came in?
No.
You don't want to know her at all? You don't want to know me, do you? Do you know I've been working on the railroad?
No.
No?
Yes.
Didn't you sing that on the wagon train?
No, sir.
No, I gotta say, we'll throw her on later.
Okay.
How about that man next to you? Has he ever been here before? Sir, no, you. There's nobody beside you. Have you ever been here before? No, why? You got something against us? You don't like us? You want to? You think you could do better? You want to come up here and sing? Come on. All right, stay there.
Good start here.
How about, ma'am? You're sitting here, we're having a community sing. Are you not part of our community? Are you going to sing? You just got here and you got those seats? Who do you know?
Rise up so early in the morning.
Are you moving your lips?
And hear the captain shouting. Dine up close.
To the prairies, to the oceans,
Welcome to our 66th and our last show. And we hope we'd like to introduce the head man of the show here, Joe Palaccia, over at the piano. Let's give him a hand so he won't leave him. And now you can always expect the...
Saturday from 9 to 1 on the 12th of May. Toys, clothes, and more, bargains galore. We'll even give Ed Strang away.
I saw a birdie in the sky. He dropped some whitewash in my eye. I didn't cry, I didn't sigh. I just thank God that cows don't fly.
Harry Howard.
I don't have a poem tonight, but I do have something to tell all those married men out there. To keep your marriage brimming with love in the loving cup, whenever you're wrong, admit it, and whenever you're right, shut up.
I got two people back.
Last night.
Mary had a little watch. She swallowed it one day, and then she took some castor oil to pass the time away. The castor oil, it did not work. The watch refused to pass. So if you want to know what time it is, look up Mary's brother. He's got a watch, too.
Now we're going to introduce Ed Handy. But you know, 17 years ago, exactly tonight, his wife was having a baby up at Griffin Hospital. And so just for the fun of it, we thought we'd have a baby shower here. We didn't know the baby was being born, but it was actually born during the minstrel. So... those are facts, Ed.
That's absolutely true.
Absolutely true. And the baby's here tonight.
And he's only 13.
But he paid $4 to get in. Okay, our first... Oh, you want to say something?
It's my joke. It's my call.
What I'd like to do is my son. My son does turn 17 tonight, and when a 17-year-old wants to come out and see this kind of a thing in his father's
Let's do something. Let's sing happy birthday for Grandpa Joe.
That's what I was going to do, man! Everybody, though. Matthew's his name.
Matthew.
I didn't think it was an antique sale.
Yes, sir. We'll have a
is it? What, on animals?
Well, yeah, it has a horse in it.
Will I be the horse?
Well, sort of. I'll be playing the front end of the horse, and we just want you to be yourself.
A horse, a kingdom for a horse.
You settle for a jackass.
Sure.
Gee, it's great to be young, and a lot of us out there, I mean, I think, can appreciate this song. John.
Down the wide open road I go swinging. Gee, it's great to be young. With this song in my heart I am singing. Gee, it's great to be young. Though stormy winds may blow, I'll let them blow. For each day seems to say this is my day.
That's right. Mrs. Palaccio got down this big 2x3 glossy of Joe there and hung it over the crack.
Let me get this straight. Mrs. Palaccio got a 2-foot by 3-foot photograph of her husband Joe,
yep,
and put it over the crack.
That's right.
Well, how did things work out?
Not so good. After a couple of weeks, she had to take it down.
She took it down? Why did she do that?
Well, she said the crack looked better.
Are over a sleigh, but don't watch the view. Don't concentrate on her swing, it doesn't mean a thing. Keep your eyes on the hand. She goes around the island, swinging hips so tantalized. Keep your eyes where they belong, because the hoover has the feel. Oh, send your senses real. It makes a weak man strong. Your eyes are revealing, you're fooling no one. No use in concealing, you're having some fun. But if you're too young to date, or over 98, keep your eyes on the hands. A weak man strong. Your eyes are revealing, you're fooling no one. No use in concealing, you're having some fun. But if you're too young to wait, or over 98, keep your eyes on the hands they tell a story. Keep your eyes on her hands.
Jana!
Ching, ching, ching.
from a church in Estonia the other day. No, 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 no. That, not this. The sign. Oh, the sign was funny.
The sign was funny.
Yeah.
What was so funny about it?
Well, it said, if you're tired of sin, come on in.
Oh, what's so funny about that?
Well, some wise guy came along and wrote under it, if you're not, call Maggie at 795-1111.
Oh.
At least you guys do is laugh on our last minstrel show. Please!
Why did he laugh at the first?
Be a good scout, Mary Mayhew. We have,
I'm not coming over your house no more.
Why?
Because I don't like your mother's pancakes.
You don't like my mother's pancakes?
I hate your mother's pancakes.
The very idea of coming over to my house, partaking of my mother's hospitality like that, and talking about her pancakes like that. I'll have you know that my mother has been making pancakes since before you were born.
Yeah, the pancakes I had the other night tasted like they were made before I was born.
Oh, yeah?
That's right.
Oh, is that right?
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Well, I have a brother.
You have a brother?
Yeah, and he was a hero.
A hero? How come?
He was a hero in the war.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'll never forget the day he left for the front. He came to my mother to say goodbye, and he says, Mom, I'm off to war. And my mother looked at my brother and said, Son, I want to hand you this little New Testament. And I want you to wear this little New Testament in your pocket over your heart, and it'll protect you from all danger.
That's nice.
You'll never take it away.
That's a very nice story.
Right. Then one day there was a terrific battle, Ed. The
Where?
Shots and shells were flying, and all the men were laying around dead.
Drunk.
No, not too drunk. The air was full of the odor of TNT and nitroglycerin. Did I tell you all the men were dead?
That's pretty good, huh? You know how wet
then
you are?
Then the flag fell.
Always wet that way?
Then the flag fell.
The flag fell.
Yeah, the flag fell. And the captain said, who will save the flag?
And your brother said...
My brother said, aye, sir, I will save the flag.
Wow!
He jumped over the breastworks, and just as he was about to pick up the flag, he got shot right in the heart.
And it killed him dead.
Wrong. He had that little New Testament over his heart, and it saved his life.
Oh, Jay, you're not gonna... That's really great, but you're not gonna believe. I was in the same battle.
You were in the same battle?
I was in the same battle.
Sure you were, Ed.
I swear, I saw everything happen, and I was a hero, too.
Huh?
Yeah, all the men were lying around, polluted and pificated.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, they were.
They were?
The air was full of the smell of BBDs and Vaseline.
No. The air was full of the odor of TNT and nitroglycerin.
Yeah, BBDs and Vaseline.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, the flag flopped.
Oh, no, Ed. The flag fell. Get it right.
The flag flopped. Yeah. And the captain said, who's going to go outside and get the flag? And I said, I will go outside and get the flag.
Yeah?
So I jumped over the footlights, right?
No. You jumped over the breastworks.
I jumped over the footlights.
Yeah?
And I go tearing out there to pick up the flag.
Uh-huh.
And boom, I see it right in front of me.
Yep.
I reach out. I pick up the flag. I'm about to put it in the ground. And kaboom, I'm hit right here in the heart with 18 cannonballs and 17 Coca-Cola bottles. Right here.
Right there?
Wait.
And I suppose you're going to tell me that you had a little New Testament in your shirt pocket and it saved your life, right?
Nope. All I had was one of your mother's pancakes.
Thank you.
Yeah, when Joe was a young guy, he was really a daring guy.
He was?
Yeah, in fact, he used to do an awful lot of swimming as a kid.
Oh, athletic.
But the thing that separated him from the rest of his friends, both of them, was he used to like to swim up at Pink Cow Cove. Pink Cow's Cove? Yeah, Pink Cow Cove.
Had
our time last night.
Yeah,
he was up at Pink Cow's Cove, and he used to like to go swimming completely. And one day, Joe's out in the middle of Pink Cow's Cove, swimming away, and all of his friends showed up, right?
Yeah.
And they showed up, and they said, let's play a real funny joke on Joe. Let's steal all of his clothes. So they stole all of his clothes, except for his derby hat.
Okay.
Yeah, well, Joe was an enterprising young guy, and he said, I know how to get home.
Yeah.
He said, I'm going to take the derby hat, I'm going to place it in front of me, and I'm going to walk home. Well, Joe started walking home, right? And he came to Main Street in the middle of Derby, and there, hanging out clothes on the front porch in the middle of Derby on Main Street, was Mrs. Galoran.
Mrs. Galoran.
Yeah! On Main Street, hanging out clothes. She just happened to move her clothesline that minute.
Oh.
Yes! And she's looking down, and Joe is walking by, and Joe looks up, and he's quite embarrassed. And he said, Mrs. Galoran, I am quite embarrassed. But if you are a lady, you will turn your head.
Yes.
What did Mrs. Galoran say?
Mrs. Galoran said?
Mrs. Galoran said, Mr. Bellagio, if you're a gentleman, you'll tip your hat.
The minstrel show and the gang show used to have a fellow who used to come here, Don Hemstreet, who has now moved on and out of the state of Connecticut. Don, would you come up to the stage? Can we have a round of applause, please, for Don Hemstreet? Don? We knew Don was coming back tonight. We have found out from his family that he would be here tonight. And one thing you got to understand, that Don took all of our pictures for years, our posters, and we all have individual things of the way we look like when we were younger. And, you know, there are certain people who are very important in the show and for years do things that are never recognized. So the MN got together and got this little bit of a plaque. And the inscription is, we would like to thank you for the time that you have extended to us as NMEN and for the job well done. Thank you, Jay Decco. Jay? Yeah. Had me out of focus. Every picture you took of me. And I always looked wide.
And you still look wide. Worst Inman's eight league of Miss Glory.
Great hunters.
They do, huh?
So they went up to Maine to go hunting, up to Herb's, you know, hometown.
Really?
But
Fort
they got,
Kent.
You poor Kent Maine, but they got lost on the way there.
For her?
Yes. Well, anyways, they at night they wanted to stop and sleep somewhere, so they found a farmer's farmhouse, and they asked the farmer if they could sleep in the farmhouse for the night.
Oh, lucky them. How did it work out?
Well, the farmer said, I have room enough for two of you in my house, and one of you will have to sleep in the barn with all the animals.
Really? Who decided to sleep in the barn?
Well, Jay said, you know, I'm the youngest. You guys need your rest. I'll go sleep in the barn with all the animals.
How gallant of him.
How gallant.
How did he break it out?
Well, about an hour later, there's a knock on the door.
Yeah? And what happened?
The farmer opens the door. In comes running Jay, all green and holding his mouth and holding his nose, saying, I just couldn't take the smell of those animals.
Wow.
I couldn't take it.
So how did they work things out?
Well, you know, Jay's father, you know how he likes to baby Jay all the time.
He's yeah.
Like, okay, Jay. I'll take care of it.
Let me hold your hand,
yeah,
Jay.
So Jay's father said, I'll go and sleep out there with all those animals in the barn.
How'd it work out?
Well, about 2 hours later, believe it or not, in comes Jay's father, Henry.
Really?
A former Marine and everything. Comes in, holding his mouth, turning green and all that.
Green.
He just green. Couldn't take it because of the smell.
Really?
The animals smell too bad for him.
So what did they do? Fix this situation?
Well, you know, they started looking at Herb and everything because Herb wouldn't volunteer himself, you know.
Stone Herb.
Yes. So they kind of convinced him and he said, all right, I'll go sleep there with all the animals in the barn. So off he went.
I'll go get the animals. So how'd Herb make out?
Well, about 3 hours later, there was a knock on the door, and the farmer went to open the door.
Really? And what happened?
There were all the animals.
Man, congratulations. You're the new father of twins.
Wow, twins. What did that man say?
He jumped up and he said, wow, what a coincidence. It just so happens that I work for the Minnesota Twins baseball team.
What a coincidence. Then what happened?
Well, another nurse comes flying out the door, and she goes up to the second.
What
are
you doing?
I'm a dope pusher. Hey, Sal?
Yeah?
These things come with wide-angle lenses?
Not that wide.
Oh. Enjoy yourself. It's later than you think. Enjoy yourself while you're still in the pink. That is for mine. As quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself. It's
their parishioners?
They do? What do they do?
Well, they immerse their parishioners in water.
They immerse them in water?
They immerse them in water.
Okay, well how does that work?
Well, it just so happens I was down there last weekend and I was witness to one of their baptismal ceremonies.
Yeah, well, how's it work?
Well, there was a minister.
Okay.
And there was a man helping them.
Okay,
and
that's
they
true.
Were out in the middle of a lake.
In the middle of a lake?
Yep.
All right.
Any parishioner who wanted to get baptized would walk out. They would take the parishioner by their hands and dip them back into the water and pull them back out again.
Ooh, dip them and then pull them out.
Dip them and pull them out.
Wow, what happened?
Well, they were doing just fine when all of a sudden this 300-pound woman came walking up.
My
daughter,
me. 300 pounds?
300-pound woman came walking
up. How'd they handle her?
Well, they took both of them to handle them.
Huh.
So they took her by the shoulders, dipped her back into the water, and pulled her back out, and she was yelling and sputtering, I believe, I believe.
I believe, I believe!
Yes, so they dipped her into the water again. Again, she came up yelling, I believe, I believe!
Wow!
Well, they dipped her back a third time.
Again!
Into the water, pulled her back out, and she was yelling and sputtering louder, I believe, I believe!
Well, what did she believe?
She said, I believe you guys trying to drown me!
Leaves your soul to bleed.
Subtraction. I'm going to do some math for you, ladies and gentlemen. I can read your
math. Away, tweet, 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 tweet.
Yeah, what the operator
do? Jeffrey is hysterical.
Laughing.
Gary's mad. Oh, he is livid. He is really, really upset.
Yeah.
Yep, yep. The operator says, please, can you give me the number? And Gary says, no, I'm not going to give you the number. Operator, have you ever played dictaphone?
Dictaphone?
Dictaphone. Operator, have you ever played dictaphone?
But what the operator
say? Operator said, no, I never played dictaphone.
Well, what did Gary say?
Operator, will you dictaphone in your ear and give me fairway, tweet, 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 tweet.
Ed,
yeah.
What do they call a boomerang that doesn't come back?
I don't know. What do they call
a stick.
Who's there?
Ether.
Ether.
Ether, buddy, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ether.
Ether.
Ether, buddy, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ether.
Ether.
Knock, knock.
Who's
Ether,
there?
Buddy, knock, knock.
Word
hall.
Word
hall.
Word hall, we got to put all the ether, buddy.
She will be here, I promise you. You come back about
what am I going to do if she's not here and I can't go see
I can tell you, but you wouldn't believe me. Come back about a half hour.
All right.
Yes, sir, that's my baby with Ray Tillis. Lots of life, Ray.
Open up the box, I'd try a piece of candy, and if I liked it, I'd put it on the show for display.
Oh, okay, that sounds good enough. Now, what if a case of cough syrup came in?
Oh, those are the drawbacks, but I'd have to taste the cough syrup, and if I liked it, thought it was a good product, I'd put it on the show for display.
Okay, now, what if a case of castor oil came in?
Oh, I'd have to sample that, too, but that's when I get my 2 weeks vacation notice.
It's a joke.
Hang on, right.
Okay.
Hey, you're so dumb. I'm done. I don't even care that you're looking anymore. I don't care. I don't even care that you're looking. I don't care.
You can look at me all you want.
Yeah, I can, huh?
You told me do not watch your ginger ale.
No.
And all night.
Do not touch my ginger ale.
Yeah, that's what you said. Yeah. Do not touch your ginger ale.
Right.
And I don't even care, Jay, because all night I've been drinking your ginger ale and refreshing myself, and it's almost gone. And I don't even care. I enjoyed it, Jay.
Ginger ale.
Because I enjoyed it. And I don't care whether you told me to watch it and do not touch it.
Drink some more.
I'm going to drink
more. Ginger ale, Ed. Yeah, drink some more. I'm taking that to Griffin Hospital tomorrow. I have a test.
Harry Mayhill is going to sing Our Sweet Mystery of Life. But we need a little help. Okay, Mary is going to sing Our Sweet Mystery of Life, and you're going to help her out. And because we had four last night, and they just didn't know how to do it. So when I hold up this little sign here, you will sing that. All right. I'm going to get over here.
Oh!
cooking something up with me.
Not the show. I've enjoyed it up until tonight. Tonight is the last time I'll do it for you. As you know, this is our last show. And this is the last time this interlocutor will be the interlocutor. Now, I'd like to have Joe Palazzi come up here, please.
Do the supper.
Ed and Joe, without Joe Palazzi, who is an accomplished pianist, he's one of the best. Without him, we wouldn't have had this show lasting this long, because you have to have some good music. It's all music as you go. And without the interlocutor, what was that? Oh. Without the interlocutor, of course, that's a sure sign that it wouldn't work. Joe, we want to just give you a token of our appreciation for all the years. He lives in Orange. He comes up all the time, you know, whenever Ed needs him. And
a little bit late at times.
Well, he gets here. He lives in Orange, and he comes up several times a week. He does this just like Dickie
was a member.
It didn't matter. And of course, you know, he's given us many, many years of pleasure. And I'm going to miss this show. I've always griped about it, about getting dressed and going on this thing and acting like a fool. But I'm going to miss it, and we'll all miss, I'm sure. So Ed, also for you.
Thank you.
Token is just a small little thing about paying back new people that have done so much for us. Now, who's the best scoutmaster in the world?
Hey!
Rick Perry! Hey!
Okay, Joe DiTullio is going to sing Baby Face. We have to do first time. I have to read. He knows. Joe, you know something about balloons, don't you?
I sure do, but tell me, what makes balloons go up?
Why, hot air makes balloons go up.
Then tell me, what's holding you down?
Hey, I hear you've got a dog. What is his name?
Carpenter.
Carpenter? Gee, that's a funny name for a dog. Why do you call him Carpenter?
He's always doing odd jobs around the house.
Okay. Do you have any chickens?
We sure do, and they lay white eggs.
Do your chickens lay white eggs? Well, what's so hard about that?
Can you do it?
I hear you've got an Indian friend now. And he's got a funny name. What's his name?
Running Water.
Running Water, that is a funny name for an Indian. Why do you call him Running Water?
Weak kidneys.
Weak kidneys. All right. Do you know what love is at your age?
Love's an
part of something, baby face. I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. I didn't need a show, cause I just fell in love with your pretty baby face. Baby face, you've got the cutest little baby face. There's not another one could take your place. Baby face.
Anyway, so he goes to the doctor, he tells the doctor about his problem.
Uh-huh, what the doc say?
Well, the doctor says, here, you take these pills and you'll be all right again.
All right again.
That's right.
Well, then what happens?
So, Joe takes the pills.
Uh-huh.
Then he goes back in a week to the doctor for his checkup.
Okay, so what happened?
Well, the doctor asked him, Joe, are you going regular?
And what did Joe say?
He says, yeah, I'm going regular all right.
Yeah?
But.
But what?
He says, I go at 6 o'clock in the morning every morning.
Oh, what's so wrong about that?
He says I don't wake up until 7.
Oh!
Hey, Donald!
From our skipper and advice from Tokyo Rose, we get letters down with broken, we get dizzy from the smell. What don't we get? You know damn well. Lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother, any way, shape, or form like any father, there is nothing like a day, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name. ain't a thing that's wrong with any man here.
Mrs. Helen Hunt found a purse in the back of the room. If anyone's missing a purse, you can go to Helen Hunt for it.
In the back, there was found this roll of bills.
The things that we try to do in the show is make sure everybody is comfortable. Your chairs are comfortable. We want to make sure the sound system is comfortable. So if there is anybody who's having difficulty hearing us tonight and have not been laughing at our jokes because they can't hear us, would you please put your hand up? You have, sir?
We have mumbled too much.
We mumbled too much? Bill, is there anything wrong with the sound system?
Nothing wrong with
it's him?
Yep.
All right, you're not helping us at all. I want him out. Security? Security? Oh, we have Charlie. No, that's not Charlie.
No.
No, I'm sorry, ma'am. Excuse me. Would you get out of the way, Mrs. Gillen?
No, this is my husband.
I don't care if it's your husband, man. Just let go. Let go of him, man. Show and you're going around selling this stuff. How can we do jokes and songs and stuff if you stand around walking up and down the aisle selling peanuts and candy and stuff like that? How much you make doing that?
20-30 bucks a night.
Yeah. And you think you're gonna take advantage of our customers and do that? Well, you're not. You're not. I've been in this show long enough to know that this does not happen. Get out of here. Just get out of here. Totally. Yeah, just get out of 30 bucks a night taking advantage of our people. All the way out. Out. Peanuts! Candy! 30 bucks a night!
Jane Dicko with Tim. Jane Dicko with Tim Thien. And I'll be happy. Quick, Jane, before engines
make. Said I could, Jeff.
Hold it. I'd like to dedicate this song to my lovely wife, Cheryl. She's celebrating her 29th birthday this coming week for the 8th year in a row. Hey, honey.
Is it really your birthday?
Yeah.
29? That's nice.
Way nice.
I'm going to play the piano. Move over, Joe.
Listen, we can't fit in both of them. They're getting wider and wider.
I know. He says to me last night, he says, it's amazing how this costume has shrunk over the years.
You're no small potatoes.
You look like a sack of potatoes. I don't know why I love you like I do. I don't know why, I just do.
This is a beautiful song.
I don't know why you thrill me like you do. I don't know why you just do. You never seem to need my romancing. The only time you hold me is when we're dancing. I don't know why I love you like I do. I don't know why I just do.
Good fit.
fisherman?
No, really, is he?
Oh, he's a great fisherman. Not only in the summer, but he's a good fisherman in the winter, too.
No fooling. How's he doing?
Well, what he does, he goes out into the ice. Here, hold this. He goes out into the ice.
He's a rich one day, and I'm turning
One at a time, please.
Make our audience happy. It's very hot tonight, so Jay and I will be passing out free ice water to everybody. During the course, right?
Okay, Valley Camp. John Capola. Here we are.
Yeah.
like some?
Aren't you sorry for the kill with her every weekend?
Hey, we can get that ice water.
Yeah. We got a problem out here. How many didn't get ice water yet?
Me.
Put your hands up. How many still want ice water?
Oh my God.
Okay, some of you drinking it? Alright, when I brought this from home from Cheshire tonight, I thought I would be able to have enough ice water for everybody, but it's cooled off, but maybe I can squeeze out a little bit more. Wait, Jay, wait, I got the car.
Wants it?
All right, I'll
take it. Ladies and gentlemen, right, right there on the seat. And more importantly, it makes a great disposal.
Light a rose, I'm home again, Rose, to get the sun back in my sky. Light a rose, one woman in rose, about a thousand kisses shy. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bells chime. Ding dong ding, at the least suggestion, I'll pop the question. Light a rose, I'm home again, rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Light a rose, now everyone knows that I am hoping you're the same. So here is my love song, not fancy or fine. Light a rose, oh, won't you be mine?
Light a rose, oh, light a rose. Light a rose, oh, light a rose. Dream of now, dream of then.
Some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. You may see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow you know. You know even then.
in the Derby, and he went to Yale, and he worked in the laboratory over there, and they had come across a pill that would get a person from old age to youth. And so he swiped a couple of pills, and he sent them home to his mother. And he told her, mother, he said, "Dear Ma," he said, "these pills will make you a lot younger if you take them." And in the meantime, he got shipped out of New Haven, and he went to China for a couple of years. And then when he came back, he called his mother from New York and said, "Mom, come down to the railroad station and meet me." And he said, "I'll be glad to get home." And so when he got to the railroad station, he looked around for his mother, nobody there, but there was a young lady there pushing a baby carriage. And she waved over to him and said, "John, this is me, you know." And he said, "Oh," he said, "Mother," he said, "Mother, you're young, you took a pill." And she said, "Yes, I did take the pill." And he said, "You were young enough and you even have a baby carriage, you have a baby in it." She said, "Baby, heck, that's your father, he took two pills." Now, Aunt Mandy.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill, top of the hill. My little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'd make it anywhere. Come on, come through New York. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill. Hey, number one. Of the crop at the top of the heap. My little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there,
Martin.
peculiar thing happened last night. After the show was over, a lot of people wanted to get the program signed by some of the in-men. And if you do want to do that, they'll be available afterwards. No, just it's our last show and everything. And some people thought that would be nice. Now,
$3.
No.
Europe.
Yeah. Okay, this part of the show we don't know much about because it works behind our backs. But let me read it. The moment that we've been waiting for has arrived. The 44th and last... Here? Thank you. If I step the wrong way here...
Okay.
The girls have, as they always have, gone to no expense to bring you the finest in clothes and beauty. It is with deep regret that after let's bring on the ladies. And the first one.
How I look for it, said.
To break the ice, we bring for your pleasure a gal who's traveled all over America competing in all the important beauty contests she once had. Miss Twinkletoes. If you recognize them, oh boy. This costume will also be in our tag sale next week. And now that beautiful thing, last year's 12th runner-up. She finally learned that catching a man is like catching a fish. Miss Gigi. From the peaks of Kentucky ranges, once again by popular request, comes this cutie. Her lipstick is kiss-proof, her skin is waterproof, and her breath is 90-proof. Miss Smith. I present to you a gal who, besides her intelligence, is also a singer. She has a large repertoire. I hope that means singing. Please notice how tight her tight dress shows it off. Miss Hot Stuff. Miss Hot Stuff.
Oh, baby. Baby, baby.
From Alabama, we bring to you this horrid little thing all decked out in this outfit of her own. She was a war baby. Every time her folks looked at her, they would start fighting. Miss Southern Belle. You know, we've seen better legs on pianos. Here comes our next contestant. Between shows, she took up opera singing. She always draws a large crowd. It's not the singing that attracts her. They just enjoy watching her Adam's apple go up and down. I think this should be Miss Iran. This next model just arrived from Europe, where she was chosen Miss Turkey. She sure is stuffed in the right places if you're looking for a drumstick. Miss Gobble Gobble Gobble. Next, we bring to you that mysterious creature who's been missing for the past 10 years. But here she is, her big ambition is to be a big singer. She got big, but a singer, no. Her voice teacher many years demands she stick to modeling. So we will see that she was wrong twice. Mysterious. Next we present the great Miss Coad. She was always counted on to win the Miss Turkey title on Thanksgiving Day. And she has a college degree to prove it. Miss Stuffing. I think she's got Shelton's colors too. Black and blue. Next we have a beauty who has that special something, God knows what. In the office they call her a human switchboard. When she walks across the room, all her lines are busy. Miss Zipko. What a shape, what a figure. Two more legs, he'd look like Trigger. And now for the last show, we present the granddaughter of Carmen Miranda. From here we will go to Coney Island to compete for the Miss Under the Boardwalk Queen of 1990. Actually, this looks like one of the burlap sisters. Just an old bag. This is a first. This was on last night. This is a first. Now that the Berlin Wall is down, we have been able to bring at no expense Poland's leading beauty, three-time Polish queen, Miss Kabasi. Boy, it is Kabasi. We're fortunate tonight to bring you at her insistence the very first beauty ever enter our beauty contest in 1902. She is the only active one left from the show, featuring the leftovers of the Easter parade. It is fitting that she should be here on our last show. Miss Burlap, 1902. He's on a diet too. I'm wondering if I skipped a card here.
No, you skipped two, Ed.
I skipped two cards.
Just be two others, they'll never know.
Okay. Our next reject
is the ugliest woman I've ever seen in my life. They're also the ugliest men.
Our next reject is the most practical girl who believes that courtship makes a man spoon, but this man from Manly that makes him fork over. You got somebody there?
Here she comes!
Here she is!
She
End of the mic. Speak English? You speak English?
And I feel very sad, it's the last show. All the fellas got together tonight to buy you a beautiful gift. We had a very difficult time. We didn't know what to buy you. But I think we did fine.
Don't bend too far.
This is a combination greenhouse and outhouse. Put it up in water or fertilizer, and you make the plant grow right here. Just hold on to it. Just hold on to it.
I think we're going to have something more for sale next week at the May 12th thing.
Was for the
tag
sale.
Yeah.
Last year.
Oh, that was last year.
You donated it, remember, Ed? Who cares what I said?
There's a toothbrush in the wind.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
I only need a small car. We only have a few ends, so.
It looks like tickets from the Yale Bowl. Thank you. Joe, we're gonna try G. Joe, we're gonna try G. It's great to be young first. Everybody up in the chorus, on. And maybe these people in the front will realize what we're singing. G. It's great to be young. Down the line. Thank you.
And like birds in the wilderness, birds in the wilderness, birds in the wilderness.
Here we sit
like birds in the wilderness, waiting for Ed to come.
I'll turn over my impression of memories. Memories.
Everyone say Lindbergh.
Everybody say memories.
Come on.
Everybody say memories.
Who's the little guy?
Memories.
Who is that?
They're grabbing me back.
Who's the little guy?
Get out of here!
Get out of here! Who do you want to? Let's go! Go home!
You're good! Okay, here we go. Okay. Everyone say,
Joe Palaccio!
He started it up there!
Hey, Randy!
Oh, Texas!
I'm not gonna get to Joe!
I'm not gonna get to
Joe! Start spreading the news!